slump national, underground, thunderbounds when I stomp the ground. Like a million elephants, a silverback orangutan. You can't stop a train. Who wants up? Don't come unprepared. I'll be there, but when I leave there, better be a household name. Weatherman telling us it ain't gonna rain. So now we sitting in a drop top soaking wet. In a silk suit, trying not to sweat. Hit summer sauce without the net. But this be the year that we won't forget. 1999.
Welcome back, UH. We are back for another recap of Monday Night Basketball. Tonight, we had another set of some good games. We had some battles. Most games were pretty close, with the exception of one. But the other games were, right. were pretty good games.
Yeah.
However, we started off with the Duke-North Carolina game.
Mm-hmm.
That was a matchup of epic proportions. We had Austin Brewer.
He was in the building tonight.
Austin Brewer and company versus
up.
John Pynchon and company. And again, another amazing showing by both teams. However, John just proves to be too much.
Yeah.
What do you feel about his performance tonight?
I mean, it's like always. I think they were doubling him. Chris and Austin were doubling for him a little bit there.
Yeah.
They just can't stop that guy. I mean, he's definitely, I think, no question, the best player in the league right now. Maybe even in nationwide, but definitely in our league. And he's unstoppable. I mean, he can come outside and go inside. I mean, I don't know what you do with that guy.
Well, I'll tell you what, his PPR is off the charts. I mean, the guy is playing excellent basketball.
Did
very
he have 27
efficient.
Rebounds last week?
Last week, 28, 27. And the guy is just playing great ball. John is one of those guys that it's all business. He comes in, he does his money, and he gets out of here. He's a good guy. We got to get, it's tough to catch up with him after those games because he's out so quick.
Right.
However, another big win for Duke.
Right.
It was a close game. Austin played well. Like I said, Sammy played well. As well as Chris, but again, when you got a guy like John, it's going to be too much.
Yeah, they made it closer. Well, Austin showing up made it a lot closer than it would have been otherwise. But yeah, as I predicted, Duke won. I was actually 4-0 in my predictions today, man.
Nice,
nice. Good at it.
Well, that was a good game, but by that game. And the next game we watched was Gonzaga versus Oregon.
Yeah, another close one.
Another close game. Now, Gonzaga, would you have those guys favored again?
Yeah.
Gonzaga was favored. However, Gonzaga was a tough team. They actually came out to play tonight. They were losing pretty much about 80% of that game tonight. They were losing most of the game. Just down the stretch, Eric Thomas and Jeff Gonzalez, I mean, they're just tough. Eric didn't shoot particularly well tonight. However, Jeff carried him down the stretch, but Eric kept with the setup. Eric had about 10, 11 assists. Down the stretch was really big.
Right, and Darius helped out a little bit with Oregon. Made it a lot closer than it would be otherwise. I was actually at Center High School this week in coaching. And I looked up, and Darius Wright's picture's on the wall.
Oh, yeah.
And he's got the assist record still at center high. So he's a good player, man. He definitely made it more competitive. But, I had a feeling Gonzaga was still going to pull it out.
Well, the thing about Darius is that he's actually played at Oregon, played overseas. Darius is a tough player. He and company, they played well. Like I said, Deion played well until the end. Deion had some free throws down the stretch when they're down by two, and he missed both of them.
Yeah,
that hurts. I mean, you got one of your premier players on the line. You figure you're in good position.
Right.
However, he missed both those shots, and they went on to take that game.
Personally, I mean, from a coach, because I'm a coach, from a coaching perspective, I'm watching these games, and if one of these teams would just figure out that if you played a little defense, you would win a game, because nobody's out here really focusing on D. They just come out here and they try to shoot these threes. They'll post up their big man or whatnot.
Right.
But it's just really a three-point affair, all offense, no defense.
Right.
If one of these teams came out ready to play some D, they would have a lot of success, man.
No, I agree. I agree with you. I think the best defender that I've seen from a guard position is Sammy Strotter.
Yeah.
He gets after the defense defensively. He played a great job last week against Darius. I think you're right. I think that's the biggest key to these games out here tonight is defense. A lot of guys can score. We have a bunch of scorers out here.
Right.
Not a lot of stoppers.
Right. And I don't think I'm sure they could if they tried, but a lot of them just not applying the effort. I think they're saving themselves for offense. They need to hit up that D. That's what I tell all my teams. Defense number one.
Yeah. Yeah. No. That was like I say, a good one.
Mm-hmm.
So our next game we had was that Michigan versus Pepperdine.
Yeah.
This is the game we talked about that was not very close.
I didn't think it was going to be. I was being courteous in my predictions saying 10, but I expected something like this. I mean, Michigan's probably the second, maybe third. I don't know about Duke, right? I have them ranked second, but Duke may be creeping up. I'm not sure. But either way, Pepperdine's probably at the bottom right now just because their chemistry is really off. So I kind of saw this coming.
Well, they're only down 8 at the half. It was a close game. Up until they just had chemistry problems. That team just does not get along. It seems like they got
all year long.
Yeah, they seem like they got to figure out an identity, and they just, Ralph and Jose seem to have chemistry, issues off
they
on the court.
They need to go out for ice cream or something.
Yeah,
man.
Something.
You know?
Yeah, go out and get a massage together or something.
Yeah, something.
It just seems like they got that. They got to work that out. But if they can get together, they're both very good players. Yeah. And if they can get on the same page, I mean, that team, it could be deadly.
It could be. They got the talent.
Yeah. But we have the same old song and dance each week.
Yeah.
You know, it's if eventually at one point they're going to have to click or they're going to just, you know, be at the bottom of the barrel the rest of the season.
Right, right. And then you talked to Prescott from Michigan, right?
Yeah, big Prescott. He was another force tonight. A bunch of and-one shots. Yeah. Prescott's a big 6'8 monster. He did a good job tonight. And, you know, here's what he had to say. I'm here with Big Prescott, man. You guys had a pretty good game. I wouldn't say it was very close. You guys pretty much dominated from the beginning of the game. Only one loss to Syracuse. What's your guys' secret to success?
You know, I think we actually played pretty good team basketball for a team that's just gotten together. Today was a great example of that. We had a lot of passing under the basket, open shots, a lot of rebounding, people putting their body on a man, and I think that's working well for us so far.
Very good. It seems like you guys just never get rattled. You guys play very composed. And even the close game against Syracuse, you guys still kind of stay composed down the stretch. What do you guys attribute that to?
Good group of guys. I think the very first game we started out really poorly and we turned it around in that game and we kind of played that way with a level head the rest of the time. So it's been working.
Okay. Well, it looks like you guys are setting up for another rematch with Syracuse.
Yeah.
I can't wait to see that game. It looks like you guys are kind of walking through. However, you guys have a good game next week. I think you guys play, North Carolina next week?
I believe so, yeah.
That'll be a good game. Austin Brewer's been back, even though they took another tough loss today. But you guys are... It'll be a good game.
Still.
Oh, yeah. It'll be a good game.
Yeah.
Well, good work tonight.
Thank
and we'll
you.
See you next week.
Yep.
As you can see, Prescott is big on team. Their team play well together. I think that's the key to these games. Syracuse, Michigan, all these guys talk about team. Yeah, and I feel like that's one of the keys to success for all these guys.
Yeah. And that's why our next game, if you want to talk about that, Syracuse. That's why they have all their success. Still 6-0. Still undefeated. Arizona did battle with them. It was a 4-point game. I predicted 7, but it was 4.
Mm-hmm.
So they made it closer than I thought. Arizona is definitely a tough team. Honestly, right now, I could tell you, to me, Duke, Arizona, Syracuse, and Michigan, maybe Gonzaga. But those are my 4 best.
Yeah, I think North Carolina is in there. I think they just played a buzzsaw tonight in Duke. But I think that they're tough, too. Austin Brewer,
right.
Sammy, and Chris Collins, they're tough,
right?
You know, but you're right. I mean, I wouldn't disagree with your 4 predictions. I think they're tough. It's going to be interesting down the stretch. But however, that game tonight was close. I mean, they went back and forth. Actually, Arizona took the lead down the stretch with like 3 minutes to go. But you know, again, they just have so much resolve.
Right.
It seems like Syracuse is always poised. They never get rattled.
Yeah, great
composure on that team.
And I think you talked to Ryan, and he was said the same thing, right?
Right, Ryan Nakamura had a lot to say. Let's actually go to Ryan right now to see what he had to say. So I'm here with Ryan, man. You guys had an excellent game today, man. You guys fought a tough one, 90-86, against a pretty formidable Arizona team. What happened, man? You guys pulled it out. What happened? Was it a close game, or what do you think happened?
I think we just stuck together, played as a team, even when, you know, they actually pulled ahead, like, with maybe 5 or 6 minutes to go, and then we kind of stuck together, you know, got up to our scores, and everybody just contributed. So
yeah, that was a big game. I saw you guys kind of go back and forth down the stretch, but it looked like you guys kind of stayed poised. What's the key to you guys? Is like, how do you guys do that?
I think we just trust each other, you know, whether it be me, myself, Manny, or Justin. We give it to even our other guys, and we trust them to know what they're gonna do the right thing with the ball, not turn it over, or, you know, get the big rebounds. You know, a couple of our guys got the biggest rebounds of the game. You know, we're at the line, missed a couple free throws because we can't make our free throws down the stretch. Guys tip it out, we get the rebound. I think the same thing happened the last game. So, you know, just, you know, different situations. Other guys are helping out as well.
Okay.
So.
Well, still undefeated, Syracuse. Great game, and look forward to seeing you guys play next week.
All right, Ryan.
All right, thank you very much. We had a great night tonight of games. It looks like we're pretty good with predictions, it seems like. The teams are starting to kind of round themselves out, and we're setting ourselves up for a matchup with Syracuse and Michigan, it looks like. However, it could be upsets all over the place, man. These teams are getting better. These guys are starting to click. We'll see what happens.
It's going to be interesting in the playoffs for sure.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. But, until next time, see you next week.
Have a good one.
Yeah, it's from National Underground Thunderbound.